it were always easy and if it were always perfect. And so this is part of the story, this is part of the journey. Last week, 165.8. Let's find out where I am today.
Oh, barely, barely, 165.6. So 0.2 improvement. At least.
Awesome, so we just did the body fat percentage. And despite the fact that I have not been on track with my food this week, it's been a real grueling exercise, down 1.5% body fat from 12.59 down to 11.07. So still a victory. We're moving in the right direction. And you know, it's a perfect example that it's not always going to be perfect. You know, it's been increasing in terms of toughness with getting some work stuff done. That all comes to a head Monday. And then it is hardcore back on the diet, and next week is going to be brutal, but progress, and I'm going to take the victory and feel good about it. So Tom has just called me out and on some of my language and some of my thinking. And this is one of the reasons why Tom is such a great friend and a great coach, and you want to surround yourself with great friends who are great coaches. Because my language over the last little while, as you have maybe noticed, is I'm focused on the goal, but I'm kind of limping towards the finish line. Like I'm crawling towards victory here, exhausted, but I'll finish. And that's kind of my mentality in terms of the language I've been using. And Tom's like, listen, you can cross the finish line crawling. That's not who you are. You're capable of standing and striding, fully energized, fully able to balance all these things like a winner across the finish line. I've committed to Tom that I'm going to be putting back in my cardio, just putting some simple exercises in at home because I haven't been exercising at home the last couple of weeks while I've just come to crunch time. So I'm going to be doing some push-ups at home, working towards 100 push-ups. I'm going to be doing 20 minutes of cardio twice this week at home, just fitting in little things. And next Saturday, going on a date with Shannon, going out dinner and a movie with Shannon. Healthy dinner. But the key is that, yes, there's going to be moments where little things get out of balance, but we don't have to sacrifice everything. We can actually do it all, do it well, do it with a sense of a refreshed spirit, and have an energy to our step and a smile on our face when we cross the finish line. And I need to not crawl across the finish line, I need to stride purposefully across the finish line to show you guys, hey, you know what? You can do this too. It is not, doesn't take a miracle. It just takes making a decision to do it in a healthy way.
I'm not afraid.
Yeah. It's been a ride. I guess I had to go to that place to get to this one. Now some of you might still be in that place. If you're trying to get out, just follow me. I'll get you there.
You can try and read my lyrics off of this paper before I lay them, but you won't take the sting out these words before I say them. Cause ain't no way I'ma let you stop me from causing mayhem. When I say I'ma do something, I do it. I don't give a damn what you think, I'm doing this for me. So the world, feed it beans, it's gassed up. Everything's are stopping me. I'ma be what I set out to be, without a doubt, undoubtedly. And all those who look down on me, I'm tearing down your balcony. No way fans are bust, don't try to ask him why or how can he. From infinite down to that last relapse album, he still whether he's on salary, paid hourly, until he bows out or he his bows out of him. Whichever comes first, for better or worse, he's married to the game, like a f*** you for Christmas. His gift is a curse. Forget the earth, he's got the urge to pull his from the dirt and f*** the whole universe. I'm not afraid.
We're all finished working out here, and you know, some workouts are like a neutron bomb. Like a couple weeks ago when we were doing legs and just nuked everything and destroyed everything in sight. And some workouts, like today, using Tom's analogy, this is Tom's analogy, are like a smart bomb, just targeting specifically what you want to get done with very little collateral damage. Knowing that I still have a 72-hour sprint, need as much energy as possible, Tom's done a great job of just hitting some muscles without wiping me out, but has also laid down the challenge that progress is good, but I've got to get back on track with my diet. So going home right now, I'm going to make a whole thing of salmon for the next couple of days. Get all that food going so that I can just keep chugging away on the computer and getting in the push-ups, getting in the cardio through the week, and creating even better results. So we're gonna have a great week.